Hello and welcome. This is View from the Top. I am Moidele Sharafa Isu. Carved out of the old Western state in 1976, Ogun State is named after the River Ogun. And over the past 40 years, it has grappled with many of the same challenges as other states in the country. Under-maintained infrastructure, irregular federal funding, and inadequate social services. But with a spate of reforms in recent years by the current administration, the state government has made ambitious efforts to expand and develop the local economy. Now in the second year of his second term, Governor Bikunle Amusu will be doing a self-assessment as he joins me on View from the Top today. Thank you, for Your Excellency, for joining us.
Yes, my pleasure.
Here is a quick biography before we start our conversation. Governor Bikunle Amusu was born in Abeokuta on 25 January 1958. He attended the Ogun State Polytechnic, now Moshooda Abiola Polytechnic, Abeokuta, and the University of Westminster, London, where he got a master's degree in international finance. Senator Amusu started his accounting career in 1984 as an audit trainee with Messrs. J.A.A. Adeniyi & Co. He later joined Larry Aremu & Co., where he rose to become a manager in 1989. He was also with Extra Edge Consulting as a senior consultant. In 1990, he established the accounting firm of Ibikunle Amusu & Co. He is a fellow of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of Nigeria and the Institute of Taxation of Nigeria. He was elected into the Senate in 2003, representing Ogun Central Senatorial District. He's serving his second term as governor of Ogun State. Governor Amusu is a commander of the Order of the Niger. At 40, Ogun can be said to be one of the older states in the country. Are you, as a sitting governor, satisfied with where it is in the scheme of things?
Thank you, Madele. Yes, I'm happy, but truly, there's always room for improvement. But if you look at Ogun State in the Committee of States, of course, we have good reasons, and many, many good reasons, to celebrate and to say that we have come of age, and that I think we can say we can truly too say that in the Committee of States, we are up there. So I'm happy, but there's still a lot more to be done.
Conventional wisdom that power, housing, agri, and transport are the quickest drivers for post-recession economic recovery and poverty alleviation. How is your state faring in these areas?
By the way, we have five cardinal programs: education, health, agriculture that will lead us to industrialization, rural development, and we call it rural development that will lead us to urban renewal. Then the fifth one, which by no means the least for me, is even very important, and that is infrastructural development that will lead us to massive employment generation. But if you look at the first two, they are more of social service. There is from agri, which for me will be the pivot on which all of the other will rest, because without money, you cannot probably render good health care services. Education too, you will need money to do it, you will need fund to do it. And that is why we need to now go back to basics, now use agriculture, but not just the way agriculture were done in those years, in those old ages. Now agriculture that take advantage of full advantage of maybe the value chain that agriculture offers now. And what do I mean by that? Agriculture that will lead us to industrialization. Whatever we grow, of course, we must process. Whatever we process, we must package. Whatever we package, we must market. Whatever we even market, we must transport it to the final consumer. You will notice that everybody will be working. And once the industries are now in place, they must have a place to live. They must move their goods and services. So when you look at that connection and interrelated ways in which they are, you will notice that you can't do one and neglect the other. And when you look at our proximity to Lagos, as we speak, by the way, over 60% of people that work in Lagos, they live in Ogun State, particularly those in the middle and the lower Kedah.
You talked about industrialization now. Tell us about the recent reforms aimed at boosting industrialization in Ogun State.
The truth is this, nobody, no sane industrialist or investors or entrepreneur will bring his money to where they think their money is not safe. So the primary thing is, one, security must be in place. Two, our environment will be conducive for them to come to say we want to come here. Three, infrastructure must be in place. And what are those infrastructure that we talk about? Indeed, because we are Ogun State, we've been lucky. We have this, I think, about 5 different gas hubs now, so that people can come there. We have this, our industrial basis that we have, industrial site that we have. It's now 9. Hitherto, they used to be 3. Everybody knows about just Otagbara axis. But now we have the Onijogo-Jogo axis, we have the Otagbara axis, we have the Flower Gate axis, we have the Ogijo axis, we have even the corridor for expressway we have now on the Odeda axis, the way on the way to Ibadan. So when you look at all of those, don't forget that Igbesa is just there. And we are looking at, with our rail that we are doing, our corridors with maybe the Republic of Benin. That's another advantage that we can benefit from. And all of these companies, what we tell them is this: you must do backward integration. What are those things that you need? What are your attendants, ancillary products that you must get, your raw material? So we encourage them. Yes, we have challenges, but Ogun State, not that we are not feeling the pinch, we are different. We are only, like, and I say it anyway, I have the opportunity, we are only second to Lagos. And the way we are going, in the next couple of years, I think we are already giving them a run for their money, which is healthy competition, and that's what should be happening, and it's already happening.
You just talked about IGR. Your state was adjudged best in the latest statistics released by the National Bureau of Statistics among states who did well in internally generated revenues. What are you doing right?
It is, one, largely due to the support we are having from our people, from those, both the organized and those other informal private sector, all of them. Because I realize that people, once they know that you are real, you are genuine, they support us. But let me use this opportunity and this, your platform, to let you know that Ogun State is being church changed. Honestly, in the context of Nigeria, we are being church changed. People will talk about derivation, this one. But here in Ogun State, when the RAMFAC, this revenue mobilization, when they did what they did last, I think so many years back, Ogun State was probably, maybe they will rate us to say what we are contributing to the federal post in terms of maybe by way of tax that companies paid, pays to them, by way of VAT, by way of all of those things, maybe we are maybe about 20-something position. So the money that they see distribute now, the FAC, is still based on that old, that is an old, outdated, that is not supported by what is on ground now. So you will see clearly, if they are using the oil, the crude and this derivation and all of that, you see that it's Akwa Ibom, Rivers, Bayelsa, Delta, they get this big, big money. Now that the price of oil has collapsed, has nosedive, it is Lagos now that is getting the money. Lagos in the last 1 year, of course, they were given, it was published, 178, almost 179 billion. Of course, Ogun State was given partly 60 billion. Nobody is taking to cognizance that now Ogun State generates more in terms of the number of companies that are now in Ogun State. But we've written and we will continue to shout about it so that people will know that there's urgent need for us to do a review so that they will know that this is what we are contributing to the national purse, and we should be rewarded and remunerated accordingly.